Good morning, my name is Winda Kusumawardani. Thank you for the opportunity. On this occasion, I will present my research entitled Predominant Factors That Affect Sexual Dysfunction on Patients Who Are Undergoing Continuous Ambulatory Peritoneal Dialysis. One of the kidney replacement therapies besides hemodialysis is continuous ambulatory peritoneal dialysis or CAPD, with glucose is an osmotic agent in dialysis fluid. But excessive glucose absorption from dialysis likely responsible for dyslipidemia. The prevalence of metabolic syndrome in terminal renal failure patients with peritoneal dialysis is quite common, ranging from 40% until 60%. The existence of a set of metabolic disorder is likely to affect sexual function. In addition, uremia, which is toxic, has a direct role that causes testicular damage. The tendency of an increased terminal kidney failure at a young age greatly affects the problem of sexuality and is predictive to increase the incidence of sexual dysfunction. The aims of the study to describe the sexual dysfunction of men patients who undergo CIPD and to find out the most dominant factor influencing sexual dysfunction in men patients who undergo CIPD using a questionnaire and blood laboratory examination results. This result is a descriptive analytic study with the cross-sectional approach. The study was conducted on 70 CIPD men patients in Central Java, used purposive sampling by fulfilling the inclusion and exclusion criteria established, including men age 26 until 65 years old, didn't suffer from diabetes mellitus before undergoing CIPD, did not have comorbidities such as heart failure, stroke or peritonitis, marital status, also not depressed, and taking antidepressant drugs. This study was conducted from February to May in 2020, which was divided into 59 patients who participated in this study offline that filled out the respondent questionnaire. The Indonesian version of questionnaire index of erectile function questionnaire, and also the result will record on the observation sheet the result of the respondent laboratory at the time. And 11 patients participated in filling out an online questionnaire and reported photos of laboratory results from the same month and year when filling out the questionnaire due to a policy of limiting activities and visit related to COVID-19. And the study received ethical approval from the Research Ethics Committee of the Faculty of Nursing, Universitas Indonesia. And then the result is the majority of men who undergo CIPD have sexual dysfunction. You can see in the figure 1 that 75.7% have sexual dysfunction and then 24.3% no sexual dysfunction. And the in table 1 characteristic of study patient, the majority of respondent is a range age in 46 until 65 years old, length of time undergoing CIPD in less than 36 months, plasma urea more than 100 mg per deciliter, fasting blood glucose less than equal 110 mg per deciliter, triglycerides less than equal 150 mg per deciliter, cholesterol less than equal 200 mg per deciliter, and the last albumin less than 3.5 gram per deciliter. And then the statistical test results of factors that have a significant correlation with sexual dysfunction with p-value less than 0.05 Rh, yeah, and then plasma urea, and also albumin. While the results of statistical tests are factors that have no significant correlation with sexual dysfunction are length of time undergoing CIPD, and then fasting blood glucose, triglycerides, and cholesterol. In table 2, multivariate logistic regression model, the result of the multiple logistic regression modeling showed that respondents who had albumin level less than 3.5 gram per deciliter have a 9.3 times risk higher of experiencing sexual dysfunction compared with respondent who had albumin level of 3.5 until 5 gram per deciliter after age control. And then respondent with an age range 46 until 65 years old at risk experiencing sexual dysfunction 5 times higher experiencing sexual dysfunction compared with respondent in the age range 26 until 45 years old after being controlled by albumin variable. The variable the most influence sexual dysfunction is albumin. And then the discussion, this study showed that there was a significant relationship between age and sexual dysfunction. This is related to aging process. In this study, no significant relationship was found between the length of undergoing CRPD with men's sexual dysfunction with CRPD. In this case, not how long you have been on CRPD, but depends on how effective peritoneal dialysis therapy is able to do cleaning of small solute urea between 1.7 until 2 in renal and peritoneal. The result of this study show that there is a relationship between urea level and sexual dysfunction. Uremia influence the level of testosterone to be low and hyperprolactin that affect male sexual function. In this study, the respondent had urea level more than 100 mg per deciliter, but the general condition was good and state minimal uremic symptoms. This might be due to the process of adaptation of a person with certain level of urea in the body, because some respondents in the study recently switched renal replacement therapy from hemodialysis to CRPD and had a story of higher urea during hemodialysis. Over time, there can be changes in the anatomy and morphology of peritoneal tissue, such as fibrosis, which can make the target dialysis not achieved. In this study also, the majority of respondents were in age range of 46 until 65 years, which according to MAT study, increased age in line with increasing level of plasma urea. And also the result of this study indicates that the majority of respondents who have normal fasting glucose, triglycerides, and cholesterol. In this study, exposure to glucose was minimal so as to prevent daily high glucose load, which trigger insulin resistance. This insulin resistance can stimulate the synthesis of other liver-derived proteins, including cholesterol or enriched lipoprotein, which play a role in the occurrence of dyslipidemia in CRPD patients. In this study, no significant relationship was found between fasting blood glucose, triglycerides, and cholesterol level with sexual dysfunction in men undergoing CRPD. And the last, the majority of respondents in this study had low albumin. This might be due intake and appetite of dialysis peritoneal patient is lower than the dietary intake of hemodialysis patient. Also, uremia causes systemic inflammation, which could interfere with liver work and inhibit albumin synthesis. And the last, protein loss through urine or loss during the dialysis process through dialysis. Albumin level were the most dominant factor affecting sexual dysfunction in men undergoing CRPD, in line with a study conducted by Soup on the mechanism of transport of the hormone testosterone with a serum albumin, report that when albumin level in the blood are low, make the disruption in testosterone transport has an impact on CRPD male sexual dysfunction despite normal testosterone level. So the conclusion is, because the high incidence of sexual dysfunction in men patients who undergo CRPD, so that nurses need to increase their knowledge and skills in psychosocial assessment, so that nurses can provide comprehensive nursing care according to the cause. Protein intake is as much as 1.2 until 1.5 gram per kilogram body weight per day, with at least 60% protein with high biological value and evaluation of the ability of care and replace CRPD at home is one of the intervention of intervention for albumin improvement. And then the researchers would like to express their gratitude to all participants and all parties who facilitated this study. This study was supported by Hibah Putih Proceeding 2020, funded by Direktorat Riset Pengembangan Universitas Indonesia. Thank you for your attention.